This is Don Gossett. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord.
Welcome to Bull Bible Missions, a worldwide ministry made possible by you. And now, here's world evangelist, radio teacher and friend, Don Gossett with Speaking in Tongues.
This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I hope you'll rejoice today, regardless of what your circumstances are. Now I'm sharing with you about gifts of the Holy Spirit. I also want to emphasize that the Bible tells us that in the last days, many shall receive the outpouring of the Spirit. They shall see visions and other wonderful manifestations. And I shared about my dear Aunt May Rogers, the most godly person I've ever known as a woman. And God gave her a vision. When she heard about the fact that I was dying with an infantile disease, and she had a word from the Lord, as she had this vision, she boarded a Greyhound bus and traveled over 200 miles to come to my home. And there she would do what the Lord gave her direction, lay her hands upon me for healing. Mark chapter 6, verse 5 indicates the laying on of hands works when perhaps other means seem to fail. We read in here in Mark how Jesus could there do no mighty works, save he laid his hands upon a few sick folks and heal them. Now my Aunt May's vision for my healing was on fire of Mark 16. These signs shall follow them that believe. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. And when she laid her hands on me, the Lord gave her another vision, and a prayer with it, that when I grew up, I would become a preacher of the gospel. I praise the Lord that both of those visions were fulfilled. I was healed as a baby, and thank God I was called to preach. Well, I want to emphasize this truth. I hope that you'll lay aside all prejudice and bias. I'm going to give you the pure word of God on this subject. For possibly no Christian concerning speaking in tongues has been asked more often and answered more poorly than this question. This has led many people to believe that this issue is left for imagination and speculation to settle, but very shockingly, possibly no question is answered more clearly and precisely in the scriptures than this question. What is one actually doing when speaking in tongues? The New Testament sets forth seven specific functions of tongues. Speculation philosophy will lose their grip as you carefully see the naked scriptures answering the question, what is happening when one speaks in tongues? Well, let me give you these seven verses to remember. Number one, speaking in tongues identifies a believer. For Jesus said in Mark 16:17, these signs shall follow them that believe, they shall speak with new tongues. In this case, tongues function as a sign that one is a believer. Many today agree that in this sinful world of darkness and compromise, that believers need identification, and Jesus said, these signs shall follow them that believe, they shall speak with new tongues. And the second fact I want to emphasize is speaking in tongues is telling the wonderful works of God. Listen to Acts 2:11. We do hear them speak in our own tongues the wonderful works of God. This verse shows exactly what they were doing in Acts 2:4. Now, for centuries, people have wondered what the 120 were doing when they were talking in tongues. Well, the Bible plainly answers that. Speaking in tongues is speaking to God Himself. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 2. For he that speaketh in unknown tongues speaketh not unto men, but unto God. When we encourage the wonderful experience of being baptized in the Holy Spirit, we are encouraging people to speak to God. And the next factor, speaking in tongues, could be one, speaking mysteries in the Spirit. Listen to 1 Corinthians 14:2. Howbeit in the Spirit he speaketh mysteries. Now, in your native tongue, you pray about things you know, but in the realm of the Spirit, you can pray in the perfect will of God in mysteries about the urgent things not otherwise known to you. Many missionaries tell how, in times of impending danger, when there is no way to communicate. They've asked God to put the burden on people back in North America who had the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And many of them have been blessed as they learned that after returning home on furlough, that a person who didn't know the situation had been awakened to intercede at the exact time. This function of tongues keeps the church unlimited in the things that can be talked about, and many of the devil's surprise attacks are brought to quick defeat through this function. Now, the next factor I want to speak about is that speaking in tongues, if interpreted, is God speaking to the church. 1 Corinthians 14:5, I would that you all spoke with tongues, but rather that you may prophesy. For greater is he that prophesieth than he that speaketh tongues, except he interpret, that the church may receive edifying. At this point, I want to share with you one of the most fantastic phenomena in Christianity. For centuries, people have desired that God the Creator, if he is real, would say something. And if there is some place where God could talk to people, no doubt millions would stand in line to hear God speak. Well, the earth-shocking truth is that God does talk to his church today. Through tongues interpretation, God talks to people today, people of God. Now, it isn't unusual to sit almost spellbound to this truth when you realize it's God speaking, the Creator himself, and it sinks deep into our hearts. I think it's one of the most thrilling, fantastic phenomena of our area. Many have dreamed of how wonderful it would be if the God of Christianity could only talk to them, but thank God this dream can become personal reality. So, friends, please be understanding. With those who seem to be swept off their feet about speaking in tongues interpretation, experiences like this are difficult to conceal and to know about it. Well, many wonderful events have taken place when the Lord speaks to us by the Holy Spirit. And so I want you to understand that there are seven factors about speaking in tongues. I want you to understand that speaking in tongues is the sign of a believer. Mark 16:17. These signs shall follow them that believe. They shall speak in unknown tongues. And then speaking in tongues is telling the wonderful works of God in Acts 2:11. Speaking in tongues is speaking direct unto God. 1 Corinthians 14:2. He that speaketh in unknown tongues speaketh not unto man, but unto God. And then speaking in tongues can be one speaking mysteries in the Spirit, for the Scripture talks about that truth. And speaking in tongues, if interpreted, is God speaking to believers. Speaking in tongues is also prayer. And speaking in tongues is a sign to the unbeliever. Beloved friend, if we are sincere about keeping our experience within the factual structure of God's Word, then each time we speak in tongues, we should be functioning in one or more of these seven areas. And they'll set forth here. Let me repeat them again. Speaking in tongues is a sign of the believer. Speaking in tongues is telling the wonderful works of God. Speaking in tongues is speaking direct unto God. Speaking in tongues can be one speaking mysteries in the Spirit. Speaking in tongues, if interpreted, is God speaking to the church. Yes, the Scripture says speaking in tongues is prayer. And speaking in tongues is also a sign for the unbeliever. My, the wonders of God speaking by his Spirit. And I strongly urge you to consider all these Scriptures I'm giving you, and that you can know the blessing of speaking in tongues as the Spirit gives utterance. Now, perhaps you have never heard a real discourse based on the Scriptures about speaking in tongues, yet few experiences are as well laid out and defined in use and purpose as speaking in tongues. Many a person using unscrupulous tactics have attacked this experience with destructive claws and hideous laughs in an effort to discredit the phenomena. And I want to challenge you to know how important it is that you don't identify false statements about the baptism of the Holy Spirit. It's a great move around the world, and it's marked by the phenomenon of speaking in tongues. It's really bringing God on the forefront, and I want to emphasize that. Now, a scripture that's meant a great deal to me is 1 Corinthians 14:2. He that speaketh an unknown tongue edifieth himself. You ask, what does the word edify mean? It means to build up, to undergird, to strengthen, to make bold, to add joy, to uplift, to encourage, to fortify, to bless, to improve. There's no questions what you receive by the gift of tongues. It's a waste of time to guess what might have been done. But the Bible states that you speak an unknown tongue, you edify yourself. I thank God that we have the delight of being filled with the Holy Spirit and speaking in this language the Spirit gives. For notice it says, he that speaketh an unknown tongue edifieth himself. You ask, well, Pastor Don, what does it mean when it says edify? Well, it means to build up. It means to undergird, to strengthen. It gives you help. It uplifts you. It blesses you. Speaking in tongues will improve and fortify your life. It'll give you a fresh boldness and a sense of encouragement and have you an increase of joy. I assure you that's what will happen. So I'm sharing with you the truth that I have found very real and very precious in my own life. I'm so grateful that I didn't let prejudice and bias and the opinion of men to keep me from embracing this wonderful truth of the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And I just want to emphasize it to you. Let me give you four scriptures right here. Paul, they said in Acts 2:11, "We do hear them speak in our tongues the wonderful works of God." In Mark 16:17, "And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name they shall cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues." 1 Corinthians 14:14, "For if I pray in an unknown tongue, my spirit prayeth." And then 1 Corinthians 14:2, "For he that speaketh an unknown tongue speaketh not unto men, but unto God." Well, these are truths that I hope you'll embrace. Thank God. And now let's join together in a response by praising the Lord. Let's do it 10 times. Praise you, Lord. 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 Hallelujah.
To receive the CD, Speaking in Tongues, and the CD, Gifts of the Spirit, please ask for Speaking in Tongues CD and Gifts of the Spirit CD when you send a gift of any size to Box 2, Blaine, Washington, 98231, or in Canada, Box 75120, White Rock, British Columbia, V4A-OB1. This worldwide ministry is made possible by you. Your love gift to Bold Bible Missions is your way to partner with us in winning the lost for Christ. So please write Don today. Send your gift in support of this ministry, your prayer request, and your praise reports to Box 2, Blaine, Washington, 98231, or in Canada, Box 75120, White Rock, BC, V4A-OB1. And now, thank you from all of us here at Bold Bible Missions. To listen to today's broadcast or past Bold Bible broadcast anywhere in the world 24 hours a day, go to the Bold Bible website, www.dongossett.com, Don Gossett being all one word. That's www.dongossett.com.